Why do your vocals suck so bad? Why do they sound so crappy? Why does it sound like you just like put them through a microphone, never touched them, didn't make a record out of them? Let's make your vocals sound like a record. Also, let's get them cutting through any mix. I don't care how thick it is. I don't care how much your lead is on top of another lead is on top of another lead. I'm gonna show you how to do this with one plugin. This is the Radium Pow, and this is the Exciter from iZotope. Let's go.
Hey, Vsauce.
Listen, you guys, I'm not really talking shit about your vocals, okay? Some of you guys, like, really take it personally. Like, nah, dude, my vocals are sick, bro. Just chill, all right? This is the plugin of the week. This is me showing you some plugins I like to mess with, all right? Chill down, baby. It's all good. Have a little sucker. Sucker. I got a little song I'm writing. It's really, really pop. I like it. I fuck with it. What I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna show you how I would make the vocals a little more exciting, even though they're very, very processed already. Let's do it. Ozone 9 Exciter. Oh my gosh. This thing is so good. All right, so the first thing I wanna show you is the song. I'll just show you the vocals where they're at. And then I'm gonna show you exactly how this thing works. All the stuff, the different bands and what I do and the algorithms, and man, there's just so much to see in this thing. It's incredible. It's one of my favorite plugins to just make and shape sonics of a vocal. But before I get into it, you gotta hit the like button. You gotta show some love, drop a comment, you know? I'll do this for free. Let's make it happen. Drop some kisses or some hearts or something.
Like and subscribe with notifications on Fork and I will find your home.
All right, let's go. I'm gonna play a song for you. It's all gibberish, I'm just writing.
I'm a loser, got me those got dudes. I know she's only dancing with the hot boys and that real bad bitch. Part time when you won my switch. Yeah, yeah, she played your heart like the sound of a loaded.
That's all you get. It's a little writing session here, all right? Let's focus on the vocals when the chorus starts coming in, which is right here, and I'll show you what this Exciter can do. The thing I love about this Exciter is the bands, right? So up here is where you can kind of add the bands. You just go bam, and bam, and bam, and then, oh, I'm out of bands.
What the fuck?
Came in the wrong hood, buddy.
I'm gonna look at this though, like, okay, got this, got triode, we got this band, we got 1, 2, 3, 4 bands. Awesome. I can move the bands around. Woo, 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 woo. Okay, so the first thing I think about when I put this thing on a vocal is I think, what's the part of the vocal that I really want to kind of pop more, or I want to saturate a little bit and start to warm up and tuck into the mix? Well, on this vocal, it's very cutty already, but let's say I wanted it to cut in the mid-range a little bit more. I would come in here probably like around, you know, 700, 800 hertz, and I'd have the cutoff around like 3 to 4K. You don't need to dial this in perfectly, but then I'd start to mess with this. You could see the colors, red, red, orange, orange, blue, blue, etc., right? So I'm going to go to the red one. You got all these different algorithms, analog, retro, tape, tube, warm, triode, dual triode. I find that my favorite, most musical sounds come from the tape, the tube, and the triode. Analog as well. Retro gets a little bit, you know, gets a little too retro for me, I guess. So I'm gonna start with the analog here, and you can bring in 100%. I actually, a lot of the times with any plugin with saturation or it's like adding color, whatever, I wanna hear it. I wanna hear like exactly what it's gonna do dramatically, and then I'll adjust the EQ band, okay? So that's how I do it. You can do it however you want, but I'm gonna show you how that's done there.
She's only dancing with the hot boys and that real bad bitch. 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 Part time when you want my switch. Yeah, yeah, she played your heart like.
Okay, so I'm soloing this out and I want to show you how all these different algorithms sound. And then I'm going to bring it out of solo so you can hear how it's kind of adding to the vocal, okay? Just so you know what I'm doing here.
The hot boys.
So I'm really liking this tape saturation. It's making the vocal kind of pop, and it's like, it's grimy, but it's really colorful and musical. Like the harmonic distortion doesn't sound like, you know, it's not breaking, it's not folding on itself. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna start to mix it in, right? So the amount is how much you're driving into it. It's like if you turned up an input transformer and you were like trying to clip the transformer and then you wanna mix it in, right? That's what this is doing. So this is where you're really gonna get the, what does it say? Adds more excitation. I don't think that's a word, but cool, man. Cool isotope. All right, so I'm gonna just blend this in.
The hot boys and that real bad bitch. The hot boys and that real bad bitch. Part time when you won the switch. Yeah, yeah, she played your heart like. The hot boys and that real bad bitch.
So that's pretty cool, right? Like you can go through, and now that I have like the amount dialed in and the mix dialed in, I can just flip through these and just check them all with the vocal. So that's what I'm gonna do, just so you guys can hear the different algorithms and everything.
The hot boys and that real bad bitch. 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 Part time when you. Part time when you want my switch. Part time when you want my switch. Yeah, yeah. Part time when you want my switch. Yeah. Part time when you want my switch.
So the warm algorithm is really interesting to me because a lot of the times people don't think about putting it in the mid range. They think about putting it in like the lows or the low mids. I think it's cool in the mid range to kind of soften out something that could be really peaky. Like if the vocal has a lot of 2K, 3K, or even like that kind of 1.8 area where it's just like,
excuse me.
You can warm it up and you can distort it so it kind of fuzzes around it and gives harmonics around the fundamental, which really helps soften the vocal without trying to go get all surgical with EQ, because I think that's super lame and it kills the musicality of a lot of music when people are just, you know, jam these EQs on the vocals. This frequency, get it out. You know, it's like, well, why don't you just play with the frequency, right? So here I'm just kind of flipping through this. I could show you on the top end and the middle and all that stuff, but really I think you get the idea here. The warm is gonna kind of help you tuck it back and smooth it out. And then some of these are really dramatic. Like the dual triode can really be pushy. The retro is really pushy. Like you start to distort. I think that'd be cool with like, if you wanted to distort a guitar, like in the mid range, right? Like, or in the low mids, you know, like give it a little fuzz or something. I think you could use retro, or you could use the dual triode, etc. So that's it. This is an amazing plugin. I love it. The exciter, you have other features here as well, where if you hover over them, displays the crossover spectrum, displays the post filter view, right? You have different views. You have oversampling, which can help kind of just make it sound more like just better. And then you have the bands where you link them, right? So I think what this does is so it links all the band controls together. So I use this all the time to make vocals cut a little bit more, to make them a little more interesting in a mix. Background vocals, like you want to do the radio effect and just distort a little part of it. You know, it's an amazing tool. Other tools and plugins that I recommend on top of this one or instead of this one is you have Saturn 2 from FabFilter, which is incredible. It's very, very musical. You can use, of course, like the Soundtoy stuff, but Decapitator and stuff doesn't have really multi-band distortion. But there's a few other multi-band distortion plugins out there that I really think are really great. So thanks for tuning in. Smash the like button, show some love on it. Share this video with people that want to know more about saturation, multi-band, you know, distortion, exciting, all that stuff. And shout outs to Isotope. You guys made a great plugin. Peace, guys.